Okay.
11.
12.
12. 13.
14.
13. Did she say 13?
15.
Okay, 15. 16. Okay, give me 20. Ooh. So first 10. Ooh.
Hi, my name is Rob. I'm from the United States of America, and I work here at Baby Bilingual, where we teach kids how to speak English.
Ah, look, it's a bee. It's a bee.
Go,
go,
go.
What's a cat's like? Cat's like? Like what? Like fish?
Yes.
Alright, cat's like fish. Okay, here we go. Cat's like fish. You can say music, please. Monkeys like eating bananas. Can you say? You say? You say? Monkeys like eating bananas. Yes.
So, a little bit about us and our theory. We keep only English in the classroom by native speakers of English, and the focus is on having a nice structured list of activities. You know, they change every lesson somewhat every week, where we sort of go through and cover different topics, different areas. We learn about animals and verbs and family, clothes, seasons, days of the week. It'd go through the whole spiel. And the way that we do that is we have lots of different activities to engage all of the five senses that the kids have. Everything from, you know, arts and crafts, lots of music, physical games to get them moving. Because the thing is with small kids, they can only sit for a very short amount of time, the very, very small ones. We have to get up and move around. But while we're moving and getting them to release all this wonderful energy they have, we make sure we're using that energy to create a connection with some kind of topic so they're learning at the same time.
That's what they like. Sleep again. Wake up and sleep again. What?
My shirt is blue.
Your shirt is blue. That's true. Yes, good point.
So there's, especially for the younger ones, it's very important to keep this sense of structure so they start to know what to expect and they feel safe. The very, very small ones, age 2 and 3, they really feel especially safe if they understand what's going on. They can anticipate the next activity. And just when the trick is trying to get it just before they're getting bored with it, and then you change it a little bit. And then that keeps their attention, but they still feel safe. Very important. Once they get a little bit older, 3, 4, and 5 years old, the focus is more on really building their, not just their vocabulary, but I feel very strongly that they need to be able to put these single words they're using together and use them in conversation. So a lot of what I do is really encouraging them to speak by trying to get them excited, trying to create. I have a lot of magical characters. I use puppets and stories to get them engaged, and songs to reinforce the language that they're learning. And if they get excited about what's going to happen, then you use that as motivation to get them to speak. So if a lot of times I'll have a special guest, one of my puppets or a stuffed animal will come, and it'll be a mystery. Who's there? Who's it going to be?
I think it's a parrot.
You think it's a parrot? Where?
In your bag.
In my bag? Whoa, you think it's a parrot in my bag? Well, we'll see, let's see. Who's in the bag? Well done, Sasha. Who's in the bag? Can you sing? La 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 la. Very good. La 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 la. And take your fist again, Melissa. Who's in the bag? Who's in the tree? Can you sing? The bag. Let's open it and see. Wow. Who is it? What's your name?
I'm
Owl. Owl, hello Owl, I'm Carl Chameleon.
I'm Jerry.
Oh, hello Jake, let's shake hands. It's it. And give me five.
Yes, yes.
first they learn the general things, like who's there? Very simple two-word sentence, right? But then we add to that, I have them make a fist with their hands, we talk about how to do that. They learn about knocking and wanting to see who's there. And before you know it, after some time passes, then I'm asking them questions like, what do you think? Who will be coming? Who's there? And they'll say, I think it's so-and-so, or I think it's so-and-so. And then you can, and it's all about building on what you've learned before. Once you get that down, then you talk about, okay, who came on Monday? Do you think it will be the same person? Et cetera, et cetera.
I'm tired.
I'm hungry.
I'm not so good.
I'm tired.
I'm hungry.
I'm not so good.
Careful, it's very, very sharp. Sharp, so be careful. And finally, oh, that looks like this guy. URSWXYZ. Okay, so Simeon is next. Come on, Simeon. So you can take the mirror. Is it okay? Yeah, you can see. His mouth is okay.
I think that one of the big keys for me is that if you feel like you're excited and if you understand that the way kids' minds work, then the most important thing is connecting with them. And once they connect with you, once they want to communicate with you, and if you're only using English, then if they want to connect with you, they have to use English. And that's, I think, one of the most important things. I find it very interesting that I'm still learning every time that I come to the class and I see some new things. I feel like I learn as much from them as they do from me. But still, one of the most exciting things is to hear a child say his or her first sentence. I love that. And I love that little glint of magic in their eye when they finally understand something. So that's why I'm here. And I hope you come and join us at Baby Bilingual.
Now it's time to say goodbye. Say goodbye. Goodbye.